What's up, guys? It's been a while. So, if you don't know, I write a blog on blogger.com called What's That All About? And I was writing a new blog about stuff that I can't stand, of course, you know, me. And about fears and how fears are phobias and, you know, vice versa. So, I actually had to look up some of the names of the phobias that I have. And so I went to phobialist.com and seen some very interesting phobias. These are my top 5 phobias on phobialist.com. Some of them are going to have you scratching your head because they are very ridiculous. Here we go. Now, this list is in no particular order, so let's just dive in, shall we? The first one, I'm looking at the A's right now on phobialist.com, and the first one that I see that looks absolutely ridiculous is one that's called anablephobia, okay? A-N-A-B-L-E, phobia. It's the fear of looking up. You know, we do it all the time. Looking up is kind of something that just happens. You know, it's a natural reaction to something that's above you. So, the fear of looking up is very ridiculous. Definitely one of the most interesting phobias that I've ever seen on anywhere, honestly. You know, there's a lot of traditional ones like the fear of water, the fear of deep water, the fear of, I don't know, cats, dogs, pets, animals, horses, people, large crowds, small crowds, but the fear of looking up, that's kind of ridiculous. So, number 5 on this list is anablephobia. Number 4 on this list is probably invented by an ugly woman. I'm gonna try and pronounce it right. It's kind of a weird one. It's called calignophobia. Yeah, I guess that's not hard. Calignophobia. It is the fear of beautiful women. Yeah. The fear of beautiful women. Like I said, probably invented by an ugly woman. Or an ugly woman. Probably in jealousy that every time they go out, they're going to see a beautiful woman and just be demeaned in some type of way. So, number 4 is calignophobia. Alright, so this next one is, it's probably going to take me a really long time to try to pronounce it right. But here goes. Hippopotamostrosequipedalophilia. Or pedalophobia. Hippopotamostrosequipedalophobia? I don't fucking know. Hippopotamostrosequipedalophobia. Yeah, we'll just say that. it is the fear of long words. And I am not even making this up. Hippopotamostrosequipedalophobia. Hippopotamostrosequipedalophobia. Yeah, there we go. The fear of long words. And if you have a fear of long words, then you fear that word. And that word is absolutely ridiculous. Number 3 is that one. Now, number 2 is a fear that has two different names and two different types of meanings, but I'm just going to narrow it down to one. And I think the G is silent, so I'm going to call it nosiophobia, which is the fear of knowledge. In this day and age, it seems like people have that fear. because some people don't fucking have it, period. There's another one that's the fear of learning. Let's see what that one's called. Ah, there it is. Sophophobia is the fear of learning. So I think the fear of learning and the fear of knowledge can kind of just go hand in hand together. So that's number two. Number two is nosophobia, and let me see if I can say this right again. Where is it? Sophophobia. Fear of knowledge. Kind of crazy. Now, this list is comprised of phobias that I think are the most ridiculous, absolute bogus phobias that exist. So, this last one, I'm probably not going to be able to say it because it's way too complicated. But, I'm going to try and say it, like, a couple times because it's very interesting what the actual phobia is. And this is a fear. That's the thing. Like, this is someone's general fear. Okay? There are people that fear death. People that fear time. You know, that they don't have enough. There's people that fear snakes. Spiders. You know, and even like catastrophic things like earthquakes, tornadoes, you know, like acid rain in general, because those things are out of our control. You know, those things we can't change. Death is imminent. It's gonna happen. Time never stops. It keeps going. That's where death comes along. Earthquake happens. Tornado happens. You can't stop them. And there's a lot of these that are just like, okay, somebody had to make these up that are just fucking ridiculous. So, and then another thing that really like takes these aspects and the fears is something that happens to you personally, okay? Like, you become amputated, or you become paralyzed, or you have a fear of someone who is amputated, or someone who is paralyzed, or someone that... You know, I was watching a documentary on someone who, when they were young, seen a video of gonorrhea. You know, they were walking into some kind of sex ed class, and the first thing he ever seen when he walked in was a vagina that had that was full of gonorrhea. And to this day, he still has a fear of a woman's vagina because of that. Because in his mind, that's what a vagina looks like, okay? So, you know, they can be traumatic, they can be out of our control. You know, that you know, specifies to me if it's a phobia. But this last one is just absolutely ridiculous. I'm not even gonna go in depth because I don't believe this is a serious phobia. I think somebody had to make this up to be like, man, I really fucking hate that, you know? Okay, I'm gonna try and say it. Oh, God. Okay, that's the first part. Arachibutyrophobia. Okay? And this is a real phobia. This is the fear of peanut butter sticking to the roof of your mouth. I don't need to say anymore, because that's absolutely ridiculous and totally stupid. The fear of peanut butter sticking to the top of your mouth. Really, bro? Anyway, these are the top five totally ridiculous and bogus fears and phobias on phobialist.com. If you want to, check them out, phobialist.com. Check them all out. There are some good ones. I hope you enjoyed. And guess what? Here's my son. Yeah.